Before I begin to simplify this, let's recall that the square root of x squared actually equals the absolute value of x. Okay, this is the principal square root. Okay, in other words, we want to get the positive square root, and we can ensure that with a variable by taking the absolute value. Okay, let's look at the original here. I can rewrite this as 64x squared y squared times y. Okay, we can think of that as y squared times y. We have y to the third. When we do that, simplifying, the square root of 64 is 8 times the square root of x squared is absolute value of x times the square root of y squared is the absolute value of y times the square root of that y. Now, if your textbook said all variables are positive, so yeah, note, if all variables are assumed to be positive, then you can rewrite this as 8xy square root of y. So you might see that in the back of the book, or you might see this in the back of the book, depending on what section you're in.